Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before I begin my homily, I want to thank our combined choirs who once again are providing for us such a beautiful setting for this solemn requiem, for our raised requiem. It is one of the most beautiful, I believe, and I'm very happy that we have the ability to sing this here at St. Joseph's. So I'd like to thank as well everyone on the altar who is assisting us in this Solemn Sung Requiem. Where are our dead? And where will we be after our death? A great Christian preacher has said, "The faithful departed are in peace, at rest, in the hand of God." God's peace means refreshment for those whom life has made weary. It means security for those who have wandered through this life unprotected. It means a home for the homeless and dignity for those who have had theirs stolen by injustice, violence, or apathy of those who could have made a difference. This Christian preacher went on to say that they are in peace. And it helps to soothe the pain of those who mourn soldiers, encourages the parent of a child who died too soon, too senselessly. It brings some small comfort to the survivors of this world's hatred and ethnic cleansing as they wonder how so many can be lost and so few care or mark their passing. In tonight's commemoration of All Souls, with unshakable hope, Catholic hope, the Church prays for the faithful departed whose baptismal holiness has been smudged by sin, albeit forgiven sin. In Catholic art, the Catholic Mass is depicted in many ways. One artistic rendering of the Mass, and it is, in fact, this Mass that is depicted, meaning what we now call the extraordinary form of the Mass, the traditional Latin Mass, is presented to us from the entrance of the church building, looking toward the altar with the priest at the altar facing in the same direction as the laity, what is called toward the east, ad orientem, the liturgical east in this church's case. Above the priest is depicted Christ the High Priest, along with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. With the Most Holy Trinity, and on the other side, beginning with the Blessed Virgin Mary, is the great company of saints and martyrs. Then we see behind the priest the clergy and religious and all the laity, and then below them are the holy souls in purgatory. Thus in art is captured what in reality takes place at Mass, and who are present. First and foremost, God the Most Holy Trinity gathers to himself the complete church at every Catholic Mass, the church triumphant in heaven, the church militant on earth, the church suffering in purgatory. All are present at this Holy Mass, and earth on earth, and the church suffering in purgatory. All our men are present at each and every valid Catholic Mass. At the Catholic Mass, we poor miserable sinners have a taste of heaven, just as the poor souls in purgatory also have as they await their complete purification and their joining the saints in heaven, the church triumphant. And when Jesus the High Priest offers us at every Mass, what he offers us is the only means that opens the gates of heaven for any poor, forgiven, miserable sinner. His passion, death, and resurrection, his most holy sacrifice of the cross, and his body, blood, soul, and divinity are given to us at every Catholic Mass. The Church's dogma of purgatory is a dogma of profound hope for us poor, miserable sinners in need of purification, even at the moment of our personal judgment. God tells us through Holy Mother Church that he loves us with a purifying fire that makes us perfectly holy for an eternity in heaven, which consists of saints who love God and one another perfectly and without sin. Our prayers help those in purgatory, because our prayers are acts of love and kindness to our brothers and sisters undergoing judgment and purification. In this Holy Mass, the greatest form of prayer and worship the Church has, we entrust all our faithful departed to the purifying fire of God's love, who grants us eternal peace and rest. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Grant them peace. Amen. And may all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Domus vobis, et vos. orata et fratres.
Animus sine bene dicente.
Nobis quoque peccatoribus.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus, preceptis salutaribus bonici et divina institutione formanti, audemus dicere, Pater noster qui es in caeli, sanctificetur.
announcing din.
Domino non sum dignum.
Dominus vobiscum. Anibus quaesimus domine famorum famumque quorum oratio propitia supplicantium fureus et apecatis omnibus ex aus et tue redemptionis patias esse partiti hei filius et regis Deus in saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Requiescat in pace.
Amen. Pater Noster. Et net nos inducas in tentationem. Per Christum Dominum Nostrum.